Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today I'm going to have an exciting kind of a video. A video where I'm going to do some electrical hookups here. And you know, you ever heard that saying, don't do as I do as I say? Well, in this particular video, a little bit of a twist on that. Don't do as I'm doing and don't listen to anything I say, because because it's completely unorthodox kind of electrical wiring, and it doesn't match any building codes. And yeah, I would say I can't recommend it, but for me, I think it's perfectly safe. You take a look and you let me know what you think. But I'm going to wire up this couple of breakers in this box. I'll show you everything, and let's go over and take a look, and I'll show you what I got going on here.
I'm going to start off right here. We're going to need this soldering iron, and this is just to clean the soldering tip. And then we got some rosin core solder, and we got two breakers, and this is the panel right here. And this is all going to be for my power inverter, my new power inverter I got. And I'll show you that in a second. But here I've got four. These are just like, I guess you'd call them power cords, 15 amp power cords. And I'll show you them. I need four of them. And here we go with the, these are just strain reliefs. You know, you can use a different type of connections that go to your box, and some wire connectors. And I need that warning label, and we're going to use this board. So I'll bring you back when I got this all tore apart. We'll start putting this together, and you're probably never going to see anything like this again on YouTube. But let's get to it right now. Okay, we're back. And now I'm just going to show you right here is just soldering the end of this wire, and then I'll explain the reason why I'm doing this. So I'm just going to solder this wire on here. You don't want to have gobs of solder on or anything like that. Just want enough just to have it wick all the way along. You don't want any blobs, just like that. Okay, what you're looking at right there is the breaker, the one side of the breaker. So you would put your one hot wire there, and then on the other side, well, it goes in here, and I have that attached. I'll show you a closer look of it later, but the whole idea behind this is, the way I've done this is, I'm going to put this wire in first before I actually install the breaker. So as you can see there, all I'm doing is, I got the front wires in here, and I got the ground and the neutral wire, just like that. And I'm going to bring in another cable from the other side here, and the one conductor will go down here, which would be the black or the hot wire, and the other one is right here. So all I'm really doing is just putting two extension cords together, more or less, you know, the ground and the neutral to the ground and the neutral here, and then just using this breaker as your safety in between, just splicing in the hot wire. So I'll show you what the extension cord looks like next, and what I'm going to do with these two wires. And all I've done so far is just strip back the extension cord to the length that I need, and the one that I soldered, well, this is it right here. And all I did was took the casing off from here. So I'm going to put it in here like this, and these two wires will go here, and this one here will go to the breaker. So let's get to that next. And if you've ever used these before, these are just strain reliefs. So as you put the cable through, and I'll put the cable through here, when you put the cable through like this, I'll just take it out here. I'll give you a good look in the box after up close. But you put the cable through like this, and you just bring it through till it just comes through here. And then when you start winding this down on the side, it just tightens up right here. So I'll bring you back in the next part, and I'll show you what I'm doing. Well, as you can see, I got the breaker all screwed in there, and it's a lot easier to tighten it up rather than being inside the unit, I find. And you just hook it into the bottom here. There's only one way you can put this in anyways. You hook it into the bottom and it just presses down, and it's easy as that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to straighten out these wires. But the next step I'm going to show you is what I do with this part right here, which is the electrical wires. So I'm going to show you something that I do, and what I do is I solder them. So what I'm going to do is just come over here and just solder them up. I mean, it doesn't take much to solder them, and you know, they're not going to come apart. Now remember, all this fuse box is all made so that it uses solid wires in the first place. So that's why you have to actually solder the wires that go to the breakers, because they're not meant for stranded wire. And this whole project that I'm building here, well, it's kind of, like I said in the beginning, kind of unorthodox, but for my purpose it's going to work, right? And I'm going to show you at the end here exactly how this all fits together and the reason why I'm doing this. So yeah, soldering them together I think is a lot better than just putting a MAR connector on. So what I'm going to do, I'll bring you back, I'll show you the MAR connectors on, and I always like to tape them up as well. Well, everything is done, and I mounted it on a board, and as you can see, here is my inverter. So I would have the two lines going out, and these are 6-foot cords, and they're both good for 15 amps or 1850 watts. And as you could see, both these cords come down to the bottom. I'll take the panel off here, and if we take a look inside, so this would be one side here, this would be the other side here. So the black wires match the black wires at the top, and the rest are all put with a MAR connector, and I showed you that, and I soldered them. And of course comes along, so the top will go over and plug in here. So the reason why I put this on here is because if you were to not turn the power inverter off, these here, when you unplug them, would have power going to them. So I'll show you up at my camp. I'm probably going to go up there maybe the next video, and I'm going to install this. But this is where the hazard comes in. You should never have a plug like this that could have you're supposed to actually have the female part of this and not the male part. Now the way I've designed my camp is everything is plug and play. So this will plug into one side of the receptacle. This will go to the other side of the receptacle. The split in between the receptacle is two separate 15 amps. So I took the center blade out, and this is going to power half of the cabin. This powers the other half. So I can run two separate 15 amp circuits. And that's pretty much it right there. So what I'll do next is I'll explain a bit more here. Just hold on a second.
Well, I thought I'd answer some questions ahead of time. This is the power cord I got, and a lot of people are going to wonder, you know, like, you could have just bought some, you know, extension cord wire and put some ends on yourself. Well, you know what? I paid $7 for these. And, you know, the plugs are already molded on. You know, how much easier is this? So you can just imagine how easy this is going to install at my camp. All I have to do is just put the two conductors on the back, the positive and the negative. Put these two extension cords in. These two go into the wall. And I've drilled already two holes here just to mount it. Now, you'll see the spot where I actually left. If you've been following the channel, I left a little stub like this much because I knew I was going to do this in the future. And I'll explain a little bit more into detail how this all operates. And like I say, this part here, yeah, you really don't want to fool around with this kind of stuff. But of course, this is only for me, what I do. I don't recommend anybody else doing this because it could be very dangerous if somebody were to pull this on the wall. Well, these two conductors, they're live, right? So you got to be careful what you're doing, and this is only for me and what I do at my place. And of course I put a warning label on it, and you know what, there's nobody else who's going to touch this stuff, right, except for me. So I'm going to install it all. I'm going to explain a little bit more about the whole system, you know, the battery cables, the breaker, the actual inverter unit itself, how it pairs to my solar array that I have, my battery bank. It all comes together, and you really have to have a little bit of experimentation in the past to know what your capabilities are. And for me at my cabin, I'll show you the breakdown of exactly how I've got it designed. And I have duplicate sources of electricity. I've got my generator, and then I have my power inverter system. And it's quite interesting, and I'm going to show you that coming up real soon. So thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Follow along, and maybe you could pick something up from this that you didn't learn before, you know, about alternative type of doing things. And it's entirely up to you whether, you know, you want to follow along like something that I've done, which I can't recommend, because I know that this is not to code, and you know what, it's highly hazardous if you don't know what you're doing, right? So the best thing to do is consult a professional. There's lots of professionals. I have some great professionals on my channel. They're electricians, electrical engineers, and I'd be curious to hear your comments, what you think about this type of a setup, and I'll show you the complete setup in the next video, hopefully. So these guys come back again. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. And find some interesting things on YouTube to watch. And for me, I find this interesting. Cheers.